Have you ever thought about how much should you risk in the financial world or other parts of your life? Should jump all in or take the plunge or stand back and let caution win the day? Well, there's an engineering discipline that deals with that, and it's called risk management. And Professor Whitt, himself a professor of the Industrial Engineering and Operations Research Department, will tell you everything about it and the contribution that risk management pioneer Cyrus Derman has made.
Cyrus Derman was fortunate. He was here in the beginning. He helped create a new field, and he helped create the Department of Industrial Engineering and Operations Research, positioning it to the prominence that we currently hold today. To understand Derman's accomplishment, let us step back and look at the development of the field of industrial engineering and operations research. Early industrial engineers like Frederick Winslow Taylor had discovered that the scientific method could dramatically increase industrial and business efficiency. Operations research, which emerged during the Second World War to advance the military effort, expanded that insight by developing sophisticated mathematical models and algorithms. Cy Derman entered that world in 1954, immediately after completing his PhD in statistics from Columbia. Soon after arriving, he started to develop a theory of decision-making under uncertainty. That is illustrated by the Markov decision process state diagram at the right. Derman and his academic descendants create a large part of the current theory. That theory provides a general framework for risk management that is depicted on the right, somewhat abstractly, and also somewhat pachydermistically, right? Well, and what does risk management do? It helps us think systematically about these risks. Today, risk management is being used in the financial world, in medicine, and in other areas. Today, the tradition of Derman's work in decision-making under uncertainty and risk management lives on in the work of many engineers at Columbia. A great example is the work of Garud Iyengar, currently chair of IEOR.
Thank you, Ward, for this great introduction. I'm interested in risk and the way risk manifests itself in networks. Networks appear to be everywhere today. Traditionally, in operations research, we have concerned ourselves with supply chain networks, communication networks, traffic networks. Now, more and more, we start thinking about social networks, epidemic networks, networks of financial firms, networks of insurance companies, reinsurance companies, and so on. I'm particularly interested in risk contagion and systemic risk. That is, the risk of the entire network collapsing. The network that you see here on the slide is the interbank lending network of some of the major financial firms in the world. How does one measure the risk of this network? My interest in this subject began with the financial crisis and the multitude of different risk measures that were proposed in its aftermath. What do these risk measures capture? Is there a unified way of thinking about all of these risk measures? These were some of the questions that motivated me to take up research in this area. With Siamak Moa Levy, a faculty member in the business school, Chen Chen, a graduate student, now a faculty member at the Shanghai Tech University, I created the first axiomatic framework for understanding systemic risk. This framework allows you to take a risk measure and unpack it in terms of the assumptions it's making and the loophole that it's leaving open. The framework also allows you to take a particular way of measuring risk and improving it, and also minimizing the impact of systemic collapses. Recently, we have extended this framework to account for the risk, not in just the network of firms, but also the assets that they are holding. Now, let's take a completely different context. The network that you see on the slide right now is the supply chain of the global supply chain of a large laptop manufacturer. As you can see, parts are moving all over the world, often many times over, before a laptop gets manufactured. How does one manage the risk of this network? In financial network, contagion occurs because of very high leverage or very high concentration of assets. In a supply chain network, disturbances propagate because of very high degree of specialization. Each entity on this network produces very few components and relies on other suppliers for the rest, and they hold very little inventory to minimize costs. But low inventory also means that there is very little safety stock to absorb any shocks. Consequently, weather events or political events happening in one part of the world propagate through the supply chain to adversely and sometimes severely affect the economy in different parts of the world. Recently, we have been able to show that techniques that we developed to understand risk in financial networks, surprisingly, transfer almost as is to understanding risk in supply chain networks. These techniques allow us to identify vulnerabilities in the supply chains and also suggest very effective mitigation strategies. Currently, we are extending these same ideas to understanding risk, in particular systemic risk, in power grids and in epidemic networks. And we hope that soon we'll have a framework that can help us understand risk and do risk management for general networks. Thank you.